Hi friends, we're going to continue our work on multiplying four digits times three digits this time. I want you to be able to see our whole mat, so I'm gonna scooch it a bit over. Okay, so we're gonna bring in our checkerboard mat again so that you can see what exactly we are doing when we do these multiplication problems. So now I have a four-digit number multiplied by a two-digit number. This tells us how many partial products we're going to have. We're going to have two because there's two digits in that number. Okay, so I'm gonna scooch this over here. And I have laid out my cards or my paper so that it says 5,367 and it's multiplied by 30. Four. It's 30 because it's in the tens place. See? 34. This is thousands, hundreds, tens, units. Thousands, hundreds, tens, units. Okay? So, first we need to know that this tells us what type of beads, and this tells us how many times. Just like over here it does. We're going to use 5 beads, 3 beads, 6 beads, 7 beads, 34 times. Okay, so let's do that. 5, 3, 6, 7. So here's 5,367 one time. We want it to be 4 times in the units place because we're multiplying by 4 in our units place. So I will get more of each bead so that we have the right amount. So here's 5,000 4 times. Now I need 300 4 times. Here is 300 4 times. Here's 60. 4 times. It's 60 because it's in the tens column. And now we're at units, so this is just 7. And we need 7 4 times. Okay, so now we have 5,367 4 times. Well, now we're going to use the same beads, but we're now multiplying everything by 30. Okay, so let's get my 5 beads, and I'm multiplying it by 30. Now I'm going to get my 3 beads. Again, I'm multiplying it by 30. Here's my 6 beads. Multiplied by 30. And 7 beads. And again, I have now 30 of them because they're in the tens place. Okay. It's the same color beads right above each other. Do you notice that? And now we're going to find our partial products. Okay. This is our partial product in the units. This is our partial product in the tens. Let's write this out and see what that looks like. 5,367 times, well, we can do it by 4 because that's our units. And we also have 5,367 times 30. And that's what we're doing here. That's this column. All right. Let's find out what the answer is. Well, we know 7 times 4 is 28 because we've done so much work with our multiplication, haven't we? And if you are not one of those kids that have done a lot of work with multiplication, learning your times tables, now's your chance to do it. So 7 times 4 is 28. Now we're going to go 6 times 4. 6 times 4 is 24. Plus 2 is 28. Oops, 26. Sorry about that. 26. 26. So 6 times 4 is 24 plus 2 is 26. Now we're at 3 times 4, or really it's 300 times 4, right? But 3 times 4 is 12 plus 2 is 20 is 14. Okay, so I'm going to get 14. Like this, 14. So remember, 3 times 4 is 12, and we added 2 more, that was 14. Now we have 5 times 4, or really it's 5,000 times 4, but we can say 5 times 4 to make it easy. 5 times 4 is 20, plus 1 is 21. There's my 20, there's my 1. I have my first partial product. It is 21,468. Let's see if that's right. 7 times 4 is 28. We carry the 2, just like we did over here. We put the 2 here, didn't we? That's what we're doing. 4 times 6 is 24, plus 2 is 26. So here's my 6 and here's my 20. Didn't we carry a 2 over here too? We sure did. 4 times 3 is 12, plus 2 is 14. 4 times 5 is 20, plus 1 is 21. And we're going to write the whole 21 because there's nothing else to carry. 2. 21,468. 21,468. Okay, that's our first partial product. Now we're going to do our next partial product. We start off with a 0 because we're in the tens place. We're not multiplying anything in the units anymore because we already did that. This is tens. All right, so let's find out what we get when we do our beads. 7 times 3 is 21. 7 times 3 21. Now we have 6 times 3. Really, it's 60 times 30, isn't it? Because we've got tens times tens. Our answer will be in the hundreds. But let's just use these two numbers just to make it easy. 6 times 3 is 18, plus 2 is 20. So I'm just going to have a 20 with no answer, no beads in this square. Because it's not 21 or 22 or 24 or anything, it's just 20. So 20 means there's a 0 here and we carried the 2 over. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 2 is 11. Here is 11. A 10 and a 1 is 11, and I carry the 10. Now we have 5 times 3 plus 1. Well, 5 times 3 is 15, plus 1 is 16. So here is 16. So our answer in our second partial product, and you have to look at the color of the square, so this tells you it's going to be a 100 answer, is 161,010. So let's find out. We have to multiply this times this, this times this, this times this, and this times this. Okay, so 3 is the multiplier, just like we have up here. 3 times 7 is 21. We carry the 2. 3 times 6 is 18, plus 2 is 20. We put a 0 here, and we carry the 2. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 2 is 11. We leave 1. Carry the 10. 3 times 5 is 15, plus 1 is 16. There's nothing left to carry to, so I have to write the whole 16 right there. I count over 3, 1, 2, 3, put a comma. 161,010. 161,010. Well, now we have to add our two partial products together. So I'm going to write my 161,010 right here. And then I'm going to add my 21,468 right there. Okay, let's do our addition. 0 plus 8 is 8. 1 plus 6 is 7. 0 plus 4 is 4. 1 plus 1 is 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. 1 plus nothing is just 1. Okay, our answer should be 182,478. Let's see what we get when we combine our beads. We just bring them down. All right. 8 plus 0 is 8. 6 plus 1 is 7. 0 plus 4 is 4. 1 plus 1 is 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. 1 plus nothing is just 1. 182,478 is our answer. Do you see how we got that? This is why we do all of these steps like this. When we do our two partial products, we add them together. We make sure we carry the right things. We make sure we add correctly. And that's how we get our big answers. Okay, now you try it. Have fun.